Everyone, Nick here, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to embed your own custom color palette into your PowerPoint file. So if you are used to working in Microsoft products in Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, then the color palette that's on the screen here in front of you should be really familiar. It is the number one default, the initial default color scheme that you get inside PowerPoint. And so anytime I see a chart or a graphic or objects with this color palette, I know that the author probably didn't realize that they can customize the colors that they use in PowerPoint. And in fact, you really should, because you are better than default, right? Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do that in today's tutorial. So the first thing that I want to do or that I want to show you is a website that I really like called coolers.co. And I'll put that address into the notes below. But this is a great color generating, color palette generating website. You can go color by color by color and generate your own special bespoke custom color palette, or you can go to this page of trending color palettes that they have. And that's kind of what I'm going to do today, because then I'm going to export that and then I'm going to add that into my PowerPoint file. So let's go ahead, and I actually like this color palette right here, this middle one with the teals and the oranges. In order to export a palette from Coolers, just click on the little ellipses and then click on Export Palette. Now there's lots of different options that you can use in terms of the exporting file. So you could do it as a PDF, as an image, an SVG. You could even share these palettes on social media, Facebook, Twitter, that kind of thing. I'm going to go ahead and click on Image. And then over under color space here, I'm actually going to keep their default here, hex, because I want the hex code or the color value to come along with those different color chips. So we're going to go ahead and click export. It's going to download into our download folder. And then I'm going to go back to my PowerPoint slide here. Let's go to a blank slide, and I'm going to insert that because now it's an image. So I'm going to insert the image from this device. We'll go to, it's right here, our downloads. All right, and you can see that it imports that image right away. I'm going to go ahead and just reorient this so that we can see, we can read the hex values right here. Now, this is just an image, so I can move it around, but I can't edit it. There's no text boxes. I can't do anything like that. My color values are still the same. I still have the same Microsoft default color palette embedded into this PowerPoint file. So in order to change and update the colors that my PowerPoint file is pulling from, I have to first go up to the ribbon and go to the Design tab. When I go to the Design tab, I'm going to go over to the Variants menu here, and it's not very obvious, but you have to click on this little tiny down arrow, and then you'll see all the different theming, the fonts, the colors, that kind of thing. Go to the Colors option right here, and you can see all the different default color palettes that Microsoft provides you with. I want to go to the Customize Colors button, so I'm going to go ahead and click on Customize Colors, and then you can see these are all the different color values that are embedded in this PowerPoint file. Microsoft always starts with four values of light and dark. So it always alternates dark, light, dark, and light. Keep those the way it is. You can update them if you want to, but I usually keep them because they're important for text and things like that. And then you have six accent colors. These are the colors that we're going to update here with our Coolers customized color palette. So go ahead and click on the accent. You can see these are my theme colors right now in my PowerPoint file. This list of standard colors always comes here at the bottom, and then all the recent colors that you've used will pop up here too. Now, I've actually done this before as a practice, so you see all the values from this Coolers palette here, but I'm going to show you how to do it from scratch. So you're going to go ahead and click on More Colors. And then you get the RGB code here under this custom tab right here, or the hex code. Now we've exported our Coolers values with hex codes. So I'm going to go ahead and update each of these hex codes just manually. And you don't have to worry about the all caps. So I'm going to type that hex code in, push OK, and then you can see my accent one has updated to this shade of blue right here. Now I'm going to do the same thing for all of the remaining colors. We're going to update the hex codes. Let's see, 9EBC. We'll do this for accent 3. That will look pretty good there. 3047. This yellow, customize. 703. Accent 5 is going to be this orange. FB8500. All right, we're going to click OK there. And then we still have the sixth accent color. We didn't have another color that came over from our trending palette from Coolers. So let's just pick another shade of green. I don't really like this green. So let's go to customize colors. Now here on the custom tab, you could actually, it starts with the shade that it currently is, but you could make it darker by just sliding it like this. Or you could go over to the standard tab and pick from the standard color wheel. And let's go ahead and pick this green right here and then click OK. Now we have that there. Now make sure you name your color palette. I'll just name it Coolers. .co, and then I'm going to click on save. Now that I've saved that color palette, it automatically embeds that color palette into the PowerPoint file that I'm working with right now. So you can see the colors have actually updated on the default palette that I initially had at the beginning of this video. So all of those colors have updated, and the colors on my charts have also updated. So depending on the chart type that you're using, depending on the type of data that you use, this might be a better option for that chart instead of that default Microsoft blue, orange, gray, green, that kind of thing. So this is one way that you can use to update your own color palette in PowerPoint. I hope you use it, because the more you do, the better your slides will look, the more unique, the more engaging. People won't automatically see that classic Microsoft default color palette and just know that that's the one that you kept when you were designing your slides. You actually put a little bit of effort into creating your own custom color palette into PowerPoint. So thank you again for watching. I appreciate all the likes and subscribes. I hope you hit the subscribe button right below this video. Every time, if you subscribe, you'll get a notification for every time I post a new video tutorial in data design, presentation design, Microsoft, and Excel. I appreciate all the watches, and I will see you next time.